Oh no, it's Mr. Turkle. She wants her name. It was a warm summer morning. In his small house at the other side of the village, Mr. Tickle was asleep. You all didn't know that there was such a thing as a tickle, did you? Well, there is. Tickles are small and round and they have arms that stretch and stretch and stretch. Extraordinary long arms. Mr. Tickle was asleep. He was having a dream. It must have been a very funny dream because it made him laugh out loud. And that woke him up. He sat up in bed, stretched his extraordinarily long arms, and yawned an enormous yawn. Mr. Tickle felt hungry, so do you know what he did? He reached out one of his extraordinarily long arms, opened the bedroom door, reached down the stairs, opened the kitchen door, reached into the kitchen cupboard, opened a biscuit tin, took out a cocker, brought it back upstairs, and back to Mr. Tickle. As you can see, it's very useful indeed having arms as long as Mr. Tickle's. Mr. Tickle munched his cocker. He knocked onto the window. Today looks very much like tickling day, he thought to himself. So, later that morning, after Mr. Tickle had made his bed and cooked his breakfast, he set off for the town. As he walked along, he kept his eyes very wide open, looking for somebody to tickle, looking for anybody to tickle. Eventually, Mr. Tickle came to the post office. There was nobody about, so reaching up his extraordinarily long arms to the door. Mr. Tickle stood behind it and peeking through the crack. Inside, he could see Pat and Mrs. Goggins sorting out the post. Mr. Tickle thought he can help Pat in the naughty way. He reached in through the window with an extraordinarily long arm of his, went up behind Pat and tickled him on the neck. "Oh!" he exclaimed. "Strange. Something tickled me." Mr. Tickle waited a minute and then reached in for the door, his arm on top of the letters and parcels, paused and then took them out and put them in the van. Pat looked down to see the mail was gone. Then he turned his head round very quickly to see what was there. But there was no body there. Mr. Tickle grinned. A naughty grin. And showed himself. "Surprise, Pat," he said, "a tickletron took your parcels. Well, you got distracted." "Oh, so that's where it got tickled," said Pat. "It's a good thing you got me on the north. A tickle arrow is coming here in the main yard." Then Mr. Tickle went on Henry's father's tale. And what a day Mr. Tickle had. He tickled Twin that Sparkle while was talking to all their friends, which got her distracted for him to take the gods. He tickled Speck who was in the shower chair. "Something just tickled my ponies. It's only tickled all the ponies." He tickled Fluttershy. Riveter and Aperture. Rainbow doesn't paint it, eh? Who did that? The baby ponies, Applebob, Sweetabow, and Scootalaw. Hey, it's not me. It's not me. I'll take on those Applebaum. No, I didn't. He's going to tickle the princess. You've all got tickled for some reason, princess. But I don't see the one around her ticking. He even tickled Princess Amestre. Oh, what on earth? See what I mean? Mr. Tickle came up, surprised you, he said. Mr. Tickle, I should have known. The Twilight, did you tickle us? Listen, the Tokyo Ghost told the traps and the chick spread tall. I don't think so, said Spade. I read his book some years ago and the ending of it did tell its whole thing. I won't get tickled. So did we, said the little ponies and baby ones. After I read the Mr. Men box, said Celestia. Only can you not tickle anyone for that? Give them one tickle, and then say no. Miss Magic told me. And Craig Twilight didn't shake my arms. Of course it didn't. Then Mr. Tickle went home. Sitting in his chair in his house, at the other side of the village, he laughed and laughed and laughed every time he thought about his tickle day. Oh dear.